in Los Angeles, I'm Elie Seckbach.
Elie Seckbach reporting.
For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Elie Seckbach reporting.
For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Elie Seckbach reporting.
Expect him to be good everywhere, but is there a certain aspect of his game that kind of stands out in your mind after watching tape, if you do watch tape on him?
I know he's Dagestani, but I think he's more of a kickboxer than a wrestler. I think if I wanted to, I could go in there and shoot over 40 times and take him down, you know, 10 times in this fight. That's not something that I care to do. I really don't want to be known as a wrestler, even though that's kind of something that I think has kind of stuck with me. If you wrestle, just that everyone's just like, "Oh, it's a fucking boring wrestler." I don't want to be known as that, but if there's one aspect of the game, I feel like there's a vast difference between Saeed and I, it's in the wrestling department.
He says that he wants to beat you and then move on to fight Sean O'Malley or Marlon Vera. Do you think that's wise of him to start looking that far ahead before facing you?
I mean, that's a pretty big claim. Everybody says that, right? I'm gonna sit here and tell you I'm gonna whoops Saeed for 15 minutes. I think that's smart of him to say that. You know, that's the game. I think those are good fights for him. But like I said, I think he's got something coming Saturday. I don't think this is gonna go the way he thinks it is.
When we spoke with fighters who have been facing Dagestani wrestlers or fighters in general, they say their DMs just blow up with Dagestani. So has that been the case with you? A lot of negative DMs coming your way from the Dagestani?
No, not that bad. I mean, of course you get a few, but the worst were the Georgians when I fought Marab. It was like a parade every day. Marab would kill you. Like, just broken ass English, nothing was spelled right. Just the meanest shit. I mean, they were nasty. But now the wrestlers have been cool. And Dagestani wrestlers, I think the best wrestling in the world is in the USA. And if I have to, I'll prove that.
What separates, what's the difference between the Dagestani wrestlers and the American wrestlers?
Upper body, lower body wrestlers. Americans are better at attacking the legs. The Dagestanis are more upper body guys. And, you know, someone tall like Saeed, that doesn't really fit well with the style of wrestling that they're into.
Hey, Cody. I actually want to ask about your merch that I noticed you're pushing on Instagram. I really like the artwork. Can you just talk a little bit about what inspired it? Obviously, you're an outdoors guy.
Yeah, that's actually a picture. It's two pictures. One that I took in northern Las Vegas, and then another one I took when I was duck hunting with my dog, and they merged the pictures together. That turned out really, really cool. Venture Grooming made that for me. That was a pretty, probably cool shirt I've seen made.
Were you ever able to get that Christmas photo with all the pets?
No, it didn't work out. That Christmas photo was the best we got. We were trying to get like the dogs with like the bows on them. The new dog we have is a rescue dog. So, like, trying to get him to do anything is a nightmare. So, no, it never worked out.
Cody, right over here. Other side.
Oh, gotcha.
You know, obviously you're coming off two losses, but one of those was at a featherweight. And actually, I was just checking and was surprised to see that you're listed as the underdog for this fight. How do you feel about that, considering that you're a guy who's been in the UFC for years, you were in the top 15, and all of a sudden you're fighting a guy and you're listed as an underdog?
I've been underdog my entire career. I mean, this is like, it's not even like, I didn't even check it to know that whether I was underdog or not, I just knew I would be. I think two fights in my UFC career I haven't been an underdog. So, I mean, like, the whole underdog thing is a pretty familiar feeling for me. It's nothing crazy. The two losses, I mean, everybody brings that up, but, you know, I fought Junior Vera on 4 days' notice after I suffered something significant in my life. I had no business being there. I look back and I'm like, dude, I don't know what I was thinking, why I would take that fight. And then, you know, Murad's tough. I mean, and when I watched the fight, I feel like it really could have went either way. I felt like I could have won two rounds depending on what your judging criteria is. I don't even know what the hell judges want anymore. So, that's a fight that I feel like I win 9 times out of 10. So I'm really not sweating it. I mean, there were things that I definitely needed to change and adjust, but the reality is, like, I know that I compete with the guys in the top 5, the best guys in the world, and that's just what I know because I've been in it.
And how important is it to you to get back to fighting ranked fighters, or are you just happy to go out there and show your skills?
I mean, I don't see the point in doing this if your goal isn't to be the best in the world. In order to be the best in the world, you got to fight the best guys. I've fought nothing but hardened veterans in the UFC. I haven't had a cape route. I haven't had the Sean O'Malley walkout parade. I fought the best, and every single time one of those names come across, it's absolutely terrifying, but I'm going to do it because I have something to prove. You know, it doesn't make sense to me to fight somebody that doesn't propel me to the top.
So what was it about Saeed that made you want to take the fight?
Just name value. Name value. I mean, whether he's related to Khabib or not, I mean, that's a huge name. And he's super touted prospect. I fought guys like him in the past. I think back to, like, Tom Dukumois. That's always, like, 3-1 underdog in that fight. You know, another guy that was, you know, supposed to be something really, really special. And then I fight him, and all of a sudden he becomes irrelevant. I mean, my question would be, like, why would Saeed take this fight?
One more. My colleague Mike Hagan asked me to ask you if you've decided on what you're going to eat Friday.
I'm going to a steakhouse and I'm going to eat absolutely fucking everything.
Los Angeles, I'm Elie Seckbach, reporting for ESNewsReporting.com. I'm Elie Seckbach, reporting.
ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Elie Seckbach, reporting.